real number selection, right, on limit point of a set. So today I want to discuss about limit point of set and some other root of a point. So here limit points of some sets. Okay, I want to going to discuss limit point of a set. So before going to discuss, I want to revision some intervals and some neighborhood and Nigerian neighborhoods. Later I will define limit point of a set, neighborhood of a point. Let A belongs to R, delta is greater than 0, then the set X belonging to R such that mod X minus A less than delta is called delta neighborhood of a point A. It is denoted by n delta of A. So therefore n delta of A equal to this X belongs to R such that mod X minus A less than delta. So I am repeating again, that A belongs to R, delta greater than 0, then the set X belongs to R such that mod X minus A less than delta is called, this set is called delta neighborhood of point A. It is denoted by n delta of A. So therefore n delta of A equal to this. Okay, what is the concept which happened here? So for that I want to explain. Okay, see, this is real line. Okay, this is a real line. I want to define neighborhood, right? So for this is a set. Okay, I'm taking here a point A. A is a point here. I'm taking distance is delta distance. So this also delta distance. Here to here delta distance, here to here delta distance. So what is this point? It will be A minus delta. What about this point? See, this point I'm adding delta here, right? This point will be A plus delta. Okay, so this real line I'm taking on a point. So I want to finding neighborhood of delta, neighborhood of A. So that's why I'm taking A. So what is neighborhood of delta? Delta neighborhood of A is this. This is real line. So this is the neighborhood of A, right? In definition find I want to write set, right? So yesterday already we discussed about this. So open A comma, in place of A, open A comma B, open interval, all these things, you know that. Open A comma B, it is look like open A comma B. In place of A, what we have here? A minus delta. In place of B, what we have here? A plus delta. A minus B, nothing but interval A comma B, nothing but, so this is the interval, right? This is an open interval. So that's why I am writing here A minus delta comma A plus delta. So this is an interval, about this interval. Okay, so this is nothing but, right, which is nothing but, what is this? This is equal to, what is this? Which is nothing but X belonging to R such that A less than X less than P. So this is interval, right? Here I want to write this also, right? This is equal to, how can you write here, which is nothing but X belonging to R such that, how can you write here, A minus, in place of A, what here, A minus delta less than X less than a plus delta. So this, which nothing but this. So which nothing but already we can write this equal to. So which is nothing but we can also write this in the form of modulus. We know already properties of modulus. Okay, which is nothing but x belonging to or such that what can you write here? Mod x minus a less than delta. Okay, x belongs to such that mod x minus a less than delta. So this set, okay, let a belongs to R. Okay, delta is any positive number. Here delta is any positive quantity. A, I am taking that A is right. Okay, so I am taking A is any real number, and delta is some positive quantity. Delta is some positive quantity. So in this real line, I'm taking that A is real line, delta is positive. This set, okay, this set is called delta neighborhood of a point A. It is denoted by how can it denote by this is n neighborhood, right? Not n, which neighborhood? Delta neighborhood of a point. Delta neighborhood of a point here. So this is a concept of neighborhood of a point, right? So you can take that this is a real line. Here a is point. I am adding distance from delta neighborhood. I am adding distance from delta both sides. Then what happens? This will be a minus delta and this will be a plus delta. So which nothing but this is open interval like comp like that. So that means I am taking that a minus delta a plus delta, which equal to this. Which equal to this. So this can be written as this. Okay, already we know that mod x less than anything but minus a less than x less than, sorry, mod x less than delta nothing but minus delta less than x less than delta. I can both add, you will get this set only. So I am calling this set is delta neighborhood. In place of delta, simply you can write that n delta of a equal to what is this, a minus delta comma a plus delta. Simply in type set you can write this, or can write this also. When we are doing problem solving, you can write this equal to this, right? So this is the neighbor definition of delta neighborhood. Okay, so same as this already is now explained, n delta is nothing but this and nothing but this, that equal to m and delta comma a plus delta. So find 0.05 neighborhood of 1. Find 0.01 neighborhood of 1. So delta equal to how much here? 0.205 comma a equal to 1, n delta of a, which equal to a minus delta comma a plus delta. Delta nothing but 0.05, a nothing but 1. So 0.05 equal to 1 minus 0.05, that equal to 1 comma, that's right. So that equal to this 0.05 equal to 0.95, right? And what I am again, I am subtracting 0.05 from 1, I am adding 0.05 to 1. So we will get this. This is the 0.05 neighborhood of 1. Find 0.001 neighborhood of minus 1. Here I am taking that delta equal to 0.001, a equal to minus 1. So what happened here? Minus 1 comma minus 0.01, minus 1 comma 0.1. If I subtract this, we will get minus 1.0.01 and minus 0.999. Okay. Other thing, so find 0.005 neighborhood of 5. Delta is equal to 0.005 comma a equal to 5. So n equal to delta equal to this thing. Neighborhood of 0.005 neighborhood of pi equal to this. Pi nothing but you may take that the pi, you can consider the value, you can calculate it. Otherwise, you can simply take that 3.14 also, right? If you take 3.14, you will subtract this thing. Otherwise, you can use calculator also. You can solve this. If I use calculator, I will get this value. Okay, 3.14 something will get. Next, we will add all these things. Find 0.0 neighborhood of 1 by 2. So, delta equal to 0.001 neighborhood of 1 by 2. A equal to 1 by 2, right? So, delta equal to here 0.01. N equal to 0.01 of 1 by 2. Nothing but I am subtracting this and adding this. You will get this. This is the neighborhood of this. And similarly, you can probably do all this in 0.0 neighborhood of minus 4, this thing, right? We will get 0.005 neighborhood of minus 1 by 3. So, this is the answer. What is deleted neighborhood of point? Deleted neighborhood of a point. Let A belongs to R, delta is positive. Delta is positive. Then the set X belongs to R such that mod X minus A less than delta minus A is called deleted neighborhood of A. That means this thing, I know that this is the neighborhood of a point A. I am deleting a point from this neighborhood, so that's why I'm called here deleted neighborhood of a point to A. It is denoted by this n delta of A minus singleton A. N delta of A minus singleton A minus equal to this. So in terms of set, we may write see, this is real line here, A minus delta A plus this is delta neighborhood n delta of A. From this, I am removing this A. From this, I am removing this A. So, what is the deleted neighborhood of? From here to here, why A minus delta comma A union A comma A plus delta. So, I am deleting this. We will get this set minus singleton A. So, this is nothing but A minus delta comma A union A plus A comma A plus delta. This is deleted neighborhood of A. So, I want to do some problem on this. Find 0.01 deleted neighborhood of A, 0.0. Delta equal to 0.01, A equal to 0. So, what we know, just I want to apply this A comma A minus delta, A minus delta comma A, union A comma A plus delta. In place of A, I want to substitute 0. In place of delta, I want to substitute 0.01. You can simply you can add that A minus 0 minus 0.1 comma 0 union 0 comma 0.1. That means minus 1 comma 0 1 comma 0 union 0 comma 0.01. So this is deleted neighborhood of a 0.0. So again you can find that find 0.05 deleted neighborhood of a 0.2 minus 1. For that same as thing you can previously apply this formula. So, delta equal to 0.1, A equal to minus 1. That being deleted neighborhood of this equal to, we know that A minus delta comma A union A comma A plus delta A. Here, delta nothing but 0.05 my 1 nothing but minus A nothing but minus 1. You can add and subtract here. We will get the deleted neighborhood of 0.05 of minus 1. That equal to minus point minus 1 comma 0.5 comma minus 1 union minus 1 comma minus 0.05. Right? So, similarly, you can find the deleted neighborhood of this point. You can also find 0.00 deleted neighborhood of this point. You can similarly apply this formula. So, we will get all these things. Again, you can find that. Find 0.05 deleted neighborhood of a point minus 0.07 of a point minus of 0.07. You will get this value. Okay. Similarly, you may do your own the problems, all these things. These are other exercises in I want to find that 0.001 deleted neighborhood of 0.001. I'm taking the same value. Yeah, it is very important, very nice. So I'm taking that the point and the neighborhood will be same. Then what happened? N 0.01 of 0.01. So I'm doing minus comma 0.01. Nothing but A comma 0 comma 0.01 comma union. This is union 0.001 comma 0 comma 0.0. If I add this, you will get this, right? This is the deleted neighborhood of type. Here, you can observe that every neighborhood is an interval. So, every neighborhood is an interval. Deleted neighborhood of any point is not an interval. So, it is very important. Every neighborhood is an interval. Every deleted neighborhood of a point is not an interval. Okay, so if I take, why? Because open interval, you can say already we just now already explained it is the form a minus delta comma a plus delta. This is every point is lies in the set. That's why it is an interval. If I take this set, I'm taking that this is degree to neighborhood of 0.0. Okay, neighborhood of 0 is of 0.01. From here to here, it is contain neighborhood. Delete the neighborhood, you can take that. It is look like A comma C union C comma B like this. Okay, A comma C union C comma 0 B, right? It is look like. So interval nothing but every point between A to B which is lies entire line in C. Whereas if I take C here, if I take this value does not belong. So that means 0 does not belong into this interval. So therefore, C is not a interval. C is not a interval. Okay. So this point does not belong to interval. That's why I am calling that this is Dirichlet neighborhood is not interval, but neighborhood is an interval. Okay. You can observe that 1, 2 union 2, 3. Okay. This is not interval. Why? Because this two element does not enter interval. But every point 1, 2, 3, which is entirely aligned in S, but this 2 does not belong to this, it is not interval. You can take this also, is also not interval. Why? Because between 2 and 3 is not belonging to this set. That's why if I take 1, 2, 3, so every element between 1, 4 also belong into S. Then only we can say that it is interval. But here, if I take this set between 2 and 3 is not belonging to this set, that's why it is not an interval. Every finite interval or bounded, you can take that open A comma B plus star, it is bounded, finite interval is bounded. Why? Because already yesterday we discussed this thing, length of this interval is B minus A, length of this interval is B minus A, that length is bounded, it is finite, that's why every finite interval or bounded. Okay, union of two open interval is not an open interval. So why? Because already this is union of two open interval is not an open interval. Empty set pi is an interval. By constructing, we take that I'm saying that it does not have any bound points. That means every point of this in this is belong to this set. Why? Because this does not have any points. This does not have any points. That's why every point of this set is an interval. So I'm taking out between these sets. If I take a real number. It does not, in real number, I am taking empty set. What are the bounds of this set? I don't know about that. That means is nothing have. So, every point of this empty set is belonging to that set. That's why the empty set is an interval. Get that? Intersection of two open interval is an open interval. You can take that. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 is two open intervals. If I do intersection, intersection of these two open interval is empty set. Already just now we discussed empty set is an open interval, that's why it is a open interval. So if you take this 1, 2 intersection 1, 3, 1, 3 1, 2 intersection 1, 3/2. Intersection is nothing but which is equal to, what is the intersection? That is equal to 1, 3/2. So this is again open interval. Union of two closed interval is not an interval. Union of two closed interval is not an interval. Suppose if I take that 1, 2 union 2, 3. You can take that 1, 2 union, right? I can write here union of two closed interval is again it is closed to, okay, this closed interval is an closed interval. Is an closed interval. Why? Because if I take that 1 comma 2 union 2 comma 3, that equal to 1 comma 3. 1 comma 2 union 2 comma 3, that equal to what happened? 1 comma 3. This is closed interval. This is also closed interval. Why? Because every point between 1 comma 3 is belonging to this set only. That's why it is closed interval. Okay. Okay, okay, some cases it works, some cases not work. Yeah, why? Because union of two closed interval is not open as interval. Why? Because union, I'm not discussing interval, right? Some case it is work, some case is not work. That will be 1 comma 2 union 3 comma 4. If I take this, then what happen? Union that equal to between 1 comma 4. Between 1 comma 4, all element does not work. So if I take 2 comma 3, between 2 comma 3, that element does not belong to this set. That's why it is not an interval. Right? So union of two closed interval is union of two closed interval is not need not be an interval. Why? Because sometimes it is interval. So sometimes it may not be interval. That's why union of two closed interval also not interval. Again, union of two open intervals also not an interval. So okay, so already we have revisited this topic. Why? Because this union can be explained after deletion algorithm. That's why I explained here. So next topic is limit point of a set. Limit point of a set. So this is very crucial. Why? Because total topics is depend on this definition only. Let S be a subset of R and P belongs to R. Let S be a subset of R and P belongs to R. Please stop. P is said to be limit point of S if P is said to be limit point of S if small p only. Yeah, small p is said to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of P consists at least one point of S other than P itself. Right? I have repeated again. Let S be a subset of R and P belongs to R. P is said to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of P consists at least one point of S other than P itself. Or let S be a non-empty subset of R and P belongs to R. P is said to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of P consists of infinitely many points. So you can understand here. So okay, so limit point to concept to. I'm taking that so can you understand here? This is my real line. Okay, if I take this is my real line. So in this real line, I'm taking that any point P, right? So this is my P. Okay. So I'm taking other set. This is my S. Okay. This is S. Let S be a subset of R. Let S be a subset of R. P is said to be limit point of S. This point P is said to be limit point of S. If every neighborhood of P, okay, what is neighborhood? So how many neighborhoods exist for this point? There exist infinitely neighborhoods. Okay, there exist infinitely neighborhoods. Why? Because see, at this point at P here, neighborhood is the smallest one, right side, left side, here right side. Okay, so I'm taking that this smallest and smallest to yeah, if I take that this smaller and smaller, yeah, These are the neighborhood. So there exist infinite neighborhood for this. There exist infinitely neighborhood for this, right? Here you can take that in this point there exist for P there exist infinite neighborhoods. In this neighborhood does not contain any point of S. In this neighborhood does not contain any point of S. That's why this point cannot be limit point of S. Okay, so I want to take again. So this is real line. This is real line. Some point P is here. Same point. I'm taking other set. So this is my S. Okay. So see clearly you can observe here. Still there is some space. Okay, here still there is space. It is not on this set. This point P is not on this set. So see, be careful. So I'm discussing whether this is an limit point of S or not. If I take this point, is limit point of S or not? If I take this point, so already we know that before that, if I take this one different point, right? So you can easily can observe that this is two different points. Already we know that according to density property, between any two real number, there exist infinite rational and irrational numbers. So this is different. This is a point on set. This is different from this point on set. If I take this, between these two elements also, okay, there exist infinite rational and irrational numbers. In such case, okay, so in such case, I want to draw that a smaller and smallest neighborhood. Here, I want to draw that. Here I want to draw that smaller and smaller neighborhood. At least one neighborhood, right? Our definition says that. So our definition says that a point P is said to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of P consists of at least one point of S or consists of infinitely many points of S. But in this neighborhood, does not have any point of S. Therefore, this point P is not a limit point of S. Okay. This point of P is not limit point of S. Next, I want to take other set. Okay. So, this is my real line. Okay. So, I want to take S. S is... this is my set S. Now I'm taking a point. I'm taking my point is here. So that means here I'm taking point P. Yeah. This is my set S. I'm taking this point. Whether this point has this point is a limit point of S. Okay. I'm taking exactly on the border only, not inside. On the border of S only, right? Whether this point is limit point of S, whether this point P is right, so I will go into check, right? Yeah, if I take, okay, So if I observe that, I want to take neighborhood of this pi and 2, smaller and power, right? This I am thinking that this is smaller and smaller, right? Okay, I want to make that this also one neighborhood. Okay. So so it is look like Wi-Fi symbol, right? So this is my point. Okay, here this is my point P, this is my set S. So between this, if I take smaller and smaller, smaller, left side will come some point, right? You can take any smaller and smaller value. Delta is any neighborhood, right? You can take the delta is any point, delta 0 point, 0 0 0 0 0 any number. Right side you can take that delta P is some value. What is neighborhood of this? P minus delta comma P plus delta. Left side we have, if I take it comes to inside of this S, the point comes to inside of S. So in this, what happen here? If I take left side value, that means here to here how many P minus delta and P is different from. Account density property, what happen? Between any two real numbers, there exist two infinite rational and irrational numbers. So therefore, between P minus delta comma P minus delta comma P is inside of S. That means it has at least one point, right? P minus comma, right? So therefore, this neighborhood, if I take any neighborhood, okay, not only this left side neighborhood consists at least one point of S, but right side does not consist of what? Left side value, left side of neighborhood of P, it consists at least one point of S. That's why this P is limit point of S. So I'm taking other example. Okay, this is my real line. Okay, this is my set S. Okay. S, I'm taking some point P here. It is easy to understand that if I take any neighborhood for this, if I easily understand that in this neighborhood, okay, so in this neighborhood of P, so what happened in this neighborhood is this is my P, right? So in this neighborhood, at least one point of concern, right? When we go maximum, every neighborhood of P has at least one point of S. Every neighborhood of P has at least one point. Therefore, if I take inside the point, so from here to here, if I take any point, here to here, okay, here to here, so it is easy to say that it is a neighborhood of, sorry, it is P is the limit point of S. Similarly, you can take here also, okay. If I take on the border, P is also a neighborhood of S. If I take here, so my point, if I point is here, so same, well, starting like explained. So if I take this, this neighborhood does not consist any point of S, therefore this is not neighborhood of P. So this is not limit point of S. So now we can repeat, repeating again. A point P is said to be, so first of all, P is a real number, S be a subset of R. A point P said to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of P consists at least one point of S. In this neighborhood consists at least one point of S. So if I take here, it not neighborhood of this. If I take on the near to but not on the border, if I take this, in this case also, this smaller and smaller neighborhood. If I take big neighborhood, so if I take a big neighborhood, maybe it consists. Maybe it consists to, but our definition is that every neighborhood of P, this big neighborhood consists at least one point of S. But every neighborhood nothing but this smaller neighborhood does not consist any point of S. Therefore, P is not limit point of S. If I take on the border, a point. So in this case, what happened? Every neighborhood of this point, the size there, every neighborhood of P consists at least one point of S. Therefore, this point may be limit point of S. Similarly, You can take that p. So my s is look like a is closed interval interval only. If I take the set, it not work, but you can understood easily. If I take inside, it is limit point of s choice was there, but if I take here, not limit point of s. So this is a definition of limit point of s. So again, I am repeating here, let S be a non-empty subset of R, S be a subset of R, and P belongs to R, list of P set to be limit point of S, if every neighborhood of P consists to at least one point of S other than P itself, or S be a non-empty subset of R and P belongs to R, P set to be limit point of S, if every neighborhood of P consists at least infinitely many points. Yeah, already just now I explained, if I take that in this neighborhood, see, here, if I take here, not like consist to, if I take here, it cannot consist to. If I take on the border, so smaller and smaller closer, it does not consist. If I take inside on the border, it can maybe consist to. So, P is limit point to, P is limit point to, P is not limit point to in this case, right? So, why? Because I am taking two definitions here. If I take any neighborhood, so this is two real numbers. Yeah, you can take that. It never consists at least one point. Why? Because S is entire set, if I take like this, between these two points, so there exist infinitely many points. So that's why you can say that infinitely many points. A point P is said to be limit point of S if it consists at least infinite, every neighborhood of P consists at least to infinitely many point of S. That's why I'm calling here infinitely many, or some can take that at least one point. Okay, it works. So S is equal to 1 comma 2. Every point of S and 1 comma 2 are limit points of S. If I take that, already we just now we discussed 1 comma 2 and every point of from 1 to 2 are the limit point of S. So that is 1 comma 2. S is equal to 1 comma 2. Every point of S are limit points of S. Okay, every point of S or limit point of S. Limit point of A comma B is closed interval A comma B. You can take that. Here we can take that already we discussed on the border inside are the limit point but outside not limit point. Therefore, every point of O comma is limit point of this, every point of this is limit point of this, limit point of one comma O, this O semi closed intervals also closed interval. Why? Because every point between A and B and borders also limit point. That's why then. If I take S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I take S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So S does not have limit points. S does not have limit points. Why? Because if I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in this situation, what happened here? If I take my point P here, so in this neighborhood, does not constitute any point. It's not neighborhood. If I take on the point here, border only, right? If I take here, what happen in this neighborhood other than P itself, right? What means is that a point 3 is set to be limit point of S if every neighborhood of 3 consists to at least one point of S other than P itself. So, therefore, in this neighborhood does not consist any point of S other than P itself. Therefore, 3 is also neighborhood. 3 is also not limit point. 4 is also not limit point. 5 is also not limit point. If I take between also, this neighborhood does not consist any point of S. Therefore, this is does not have any limit point. But n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. If I take similar case of applying here, if I take the points of S, what happened in this neighborhood does not consist any point of N, therefore it is not a neighborhood. If I take between, so see our definition is every neighborhood, right? If I take big neighborhood consists any point, but every neighborhood nothing but there is small neighborhood, right? In the smaller neighborhoods, it may not be consist. So, W does not have limit points. W does not have limit points. Similarly, Z equal to take, you can take that Z equal to 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, comma, plus or minus 3. Dash, dash, dash. Z does not have limit points. So, what about Q? P by Q, comma, P, comma, Q. Why? Because Z, you can observe here. So, if I take this point, there is between this element, there is big gap. That's why, if I take this point, in this neighborhood, other than that point, does not have considered any point, that's why it is not limit point. If I take this 0, 1, 2, 3, similar already explained, right? So, if I take 1, 2, in this neighborhood, does not consist any point of W other than 2. So, that's why it is not also limit point. It can work for all elements. Similarly, it is work for Z also. NWZ does not have any limit points. Yeah, we will come to Q. So, you can come to Q here. What is Q? Q is the real number. So, I'm talking about these real numbers. So, this is my real number. Okay. What are the points of Q? You can take that Q equal to, in the points of Q is, look like, the points of Q are, it is look like this. Okay, these are the points of Q. So, it is utilized, okay, smaller and smaller values, you can draw like this. So, these are the points of R. Okay. If I take, that means, so, between endpoints, there exist infinite rational and irrational by density property. Okay. There is gap is there. So, between this gap, we can think that those points are rational number, irrational numbers. These are the rational numbers. Other thing are irrational numbers. Other thing are irrational numbers. Whether this Q, rational numbers, okay, this block color dots are elements of Q. Okay. So, I am going to check that whether these elements, okay, whether these elements, well, I am taking that this point, smaller and smaller point, whether this point is a limit point or not. Okay. So, I am taking that this whether this point is, whether this point is limit point or not, of this point. I am taking here Q, this point dot, right. So, this point. So, I want to draw a neighborhood for this point. I want to draw a neighborhood for this point, right. So, this is my neighborhood. You can take that small, right. So, for this, I am trying to draw that, this is smaller and smaller neighborhood. So, these are the neighborhoods of this point. You can observe. Okay? You can observe. Here, so, if I take anything, it will get smaller, smaller, right? So, that means, left side will get some value, right side will get, you can take any point, 0.001 also. You can take, my point is 1, you can take that 0.0001 and 0.001 left side, that means, so if I add 1 plus 0.001 and 1 plus some number, 1 minus some number. That means, this will get different value, okay. So, this value is different value, if I take anything. And, this is different value. This point is, right. This is why I am thinking that this is smallest neighborhood. Okay, this one real number, okay. So, this is real number. These are two real numbers. Both are two real numbers. According to density property, what we know that between any two real numbers, there exist infinite rational and irrational numbers. Between any two real numbers, there exist infinite rational and irrational numbers. That's why, so, there is infinite rational number, irrational numbers. Irrational number does not belong to Q, but rational numbers are belonging to Q. That's why, so, this point is limit point of Q. Not only this point, you may take any point on the real lines. Okay? I am taking that this is rational numbers. You can take that, you may feel that here also. Okay? So, what do you take that? I am thinking that this is my point. So, Earlier I am taking that this is rational number. I am taking that this is irrational numbers. So in this case also there exists two. So in my neighborhood, this was other point. This is different value. This is different value. So nothing but there exists two some real values. Both are real values. Between these two real number also there exist infinite rational and irrational numbers. So if I take rational number or irrational number also, it is limit point of Q. So in place of irrational number, you can take any real number. That means if you take any real number, if I draw a neighborhood, in that number what happens? There exists infinite rational and irrational number. So rational number belongs to this Q. So therefore, every point of R is limit point of Q. Every point of R is a limit point of R. That means limit point of Q are real numbers. Limit point of Q are real, right? Every point of R is limit point of R. So that means you can draw these things. Okay, if I take any value, if I take a rational number, so in this neighborhood consists every point of Q. If I take a rational number, so rational, this is fitting, this is rational, this is irrational. In this neighborhood, also consists any point. Why? Because I have a density property. You can take here also, it consists any point, limit point to occur into density property. So you can take example R. R, you can take that every point of R is a limit point of R. Every point of R is a limit point of R. So every point of R is a limit point of R. Why? Because so if I take any value, if I take any neighborhood, this is a real number. So if all numbers of real on the real line are real numbers, so in this neighborhood consists infinite of R. Why? Because total is real number. If I take any real number, if I draw any subset, I am taking this subset also belongs to subset of R only. Every point of R, every point of neighborhood is belonging to this set only. That's why if I take any point on the real line, it is limit point of R. That means every point of R is a limit point of R. Example, I am taking pi is equal to empty set. Pi does not have limit points. Pi does not have any limit point. So pi does not have limit points. S is equal to 1 by 1. N belongs to n. So if I take here, so you can observe here, in this nearest place, so I am observing here. Okay. I am taking the other example. So this real line, I am taking that one point. This set I am setting my set is 1 by n set. Yet this point here, my set is 1 by n such that n belonging to natural numbers, right? I am trying to find this limit point of this set. See, if I take here near at nearest place of this, 1 maybe comes here. Okay, 1 by 2 comes next. What is next? 1 by 2 comes here. 1 by 2. Next 1 by 4. But if it goes to end to infinite, that means what we have here at this value, it should look like smaller, right? So zigzag. Okay, so that means smaller and smaller, right? So in this place, what happened? The points of are very closer and closer, like this. It is look like rational numbers at zero only, not other places. So that means if I observe here string, okay, so at this point what happened? Yeah, it is like that. So okay, so if I take a point here, this point is zero. So if I take neighborhood of this point, so right side will get some point, right? Right side will get that, it will get is 0 point. You can take that as 0 point something else. So in this interval, what happened in this right side, there exists at least one point of this set. So that's why 0 is the limit point of S. Other than 0 is not limit. Why? Because I got divisible property, there is infinite rational irrational numbers. But 1 by 1000, 1 by 10 crores, 1 by 10 power of something, anything you take that, 1 by some number, so we'll get a 0 point something number. So you get again number, small and small value. That 1 by some number, we will get that. This is belonging to that set. That's why 0 is the limit point. Other set is not limit point. For this set, 0 is the limit point. Similarly, we work for here also, a plus 1 by n. It is look like here if nearest to a, there is infinitely many points. That's why a is the limit point of s. Other than s, right? Limit point of this set is a. You can take s is equal to minus 1 over 4 n, so n belongs to n. So what happened? It is minus 1 comma 1. You can take neighborhood. In this neighborhood does not contain any point of s. In this neighborhood does not contain any point 1. Therefore, s does not have any limit point. A comma infinite. So limit point of s ray is ray. Why? Because already we just now discovered every point of this set is limit point of. Okay. This open A comma B is a limit point of this set is ray. S is equal to, if I take that, minus infinite comma A. So limit point of this set also minus A comma in minus infinite comma A. So already we discussed, right? If I take S is equal to close to A comma infinite, every point of S is the limit point of S. You can take similar this also, we already discussed, right? Every point of this is limit point of S only. Okay. So derived set. Let's say S be a subset of R, the set of all limit point of S is called derived set. It is denoted by D of S. Set of all limit points of S are called derived set. Is D of S or S dash? D of S nothing but set of all limit points of S. Already we found that S, if I take that, D of S is called empty set. Why? Because it does not have any limit points. You can take here D of pi. D of pi, you can take that, it is pi. Pi does not have any limit points. So D of pi equal to also pi. If I take S was open closed A comma B, that equal to A comma B. So S equal to open closed 1 by 2, that equal to 1 by 2. Example S open, you can take the any open set, closed set, or D of S is equal to here closed open A comma B only. Okay, all can work. Here you can take S is equal to open A comma B, that equal to D of S equal to closed A comma infinite, and if I take this set also, D of S is equal to minus infinite to closed A comma B, ray. Okay, so S is equal to, if I take this, DS dash is equal to this set, already just now we discussed it. But like S is equal to this set, D of set of all limit point is so infinite singleton 0. If I take S is equal to this set, so D of S is equal to A. If I take D of S, S is equal to this, D of S is equal to pi set. N is equal to, if I take N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, da, da, so D of N does not have any limit point, D of N equal to pi. W, you can take that, D of W equal to pi. If I take Z equal to this, D of Z equal to pi. Q, you can take that, set of all limit point of Q are real number, therefore D of equal to R. If I take that, D of R equal to R. So, Bose-Jahn Weierstrass theorem. Every infinite bounded subset of a real number has a limit point. You can take that every infinite bounded subset of R has a real number, has a limit point. Already we just started that means, so if I take any bounded set, this is a real number, infinite bounded set, right? So, that means if I take any subset, this is S. This is infinite, that means A hat is infinite element. This is bounded. If I take that A, B. Every infinite bounded subset, right? This is my set is, this is my set. This is A, B. So this is infinite, that means A has infinite element. It is bounded, that means length of this is bounded, B minus A, that is bounded. So, this set already we know that you can take that close to open anything, right? Open, close into semi-close interval. This set have at least one limit point. That's why every infinite bounded set of R has a limit point. So, this is the end of the lecture, right? Thank you for watching this. Thank you for watching this.